Hi, this is Kimberly from Are You Awakening, and I am here to talk about how people meet. So I get that question every once in a while. They're like, well, how come people come into your life in like the weirdest ways? And well, it all goes back to your soul making agreements with other souls before you've incarnated. And if you ever want to learn about that, Journey of Souls by Michael Newton is a great book for that. You can learn about what the planning session looks like in between lives. You can also get hypnosis, which I did, and it was freaking wild, where I went in between the last life and this one, and I put that in quotes because there really is no time, but we'll just say on our earthly linear time frame, I had a past life and now I have this life, and I went in between and I looked at what was going on, what were my themes, who were the people that were going to be in my life. And so I did that, and fantastic insight about why I'm here. Now, it doesn't predict anything, so forget it. If you're going to find out, you know, who you marry, they don't show you that. You don't show you that, because then it wouldn't be any fun. Anyway, so people meet based on soul contracts, obviously, but let's go even deeper than that when we talk about how just you can meet someone standing in line somewhere, right? So you just strike up a conversation with someone, you find out you have a similar interest or you know the same person, and all of a sudden you're like, wow, what a coincidence. Well, we know at this point, light worker, right, that there is no such thing as a coincidence. It's your higher self that puts you there. And you're there because that person has something to reflect back to you. That's a mirror for you. There's always a growth opportunity for anyone that comes into your awareness. And if they came into your awareness, there's a reason they came into your awareness. So be aware. So you're sending out intentions all the time. You can either do it consciously or unconsciously, either one, but you're still sending out those intentions. When you send out those intentions, you're sending out a vibration. The vibration is being matched by things that are coming to you. That's what life on earth is about. All right, so it's a law, the law of attraction. I'm sure you've heard of that before, right? If not, go watch Abraham Hicks and come back to me. So you're sending out these intentions and you're bringing things that match the frequency back to you. That could be a situation. It could be a new job. It could be a move. Like, I'm moving to a really, really cool place that just dropped in my lap out of nowhere with no planning whatsoever. I'm like, oh shit, I can't let this go. This is a gift. So I've met all sorts of people in that journey from Studio City to West Hollywood. And every single person that came into my awareness was there for a purpose. They were one little breadcrumb. They were one step closer to more growth for me. So you send out those intentions. Other people are sending them out too. And when your vibrations match, that's what happens. Now you meet. Okay. So you're as you're increasing your frequency, your circle is getting bigger. It's getting bigger. You're affecting more people. And as other people are increasing theirs, the circle is getting bigger. And then your circles, once they overlap, you're meeting and you can get whatever you want out of that relationship. Now, remember, this isn't your grandpa's energy or your great grandpa's energy. All right. This is a different energy on earth now. So understand that relationships are not always meant to last forever. People may just come into your life and overlap for like 38 seconds and they can change your life. And tell me, I guarantee there's not one of you who can't say that you've met somebody who said one thing that changed your life. It happens. That's why we meet. All right. So those circles are getting bigger. New situations, new people, soul contracts, all of those things bring people to you. So if you're meeting someone, pay attention. There's something that they're reflecting back at you. It may be ugly. It may be pretty. It may be both, right? Any relationship, really, if you're sticking around someone long enough, it's going to probably be both ugly and pretty. All opportunities for growth. So pay attention. You just met me, by the way, and I'm meeting you. So talk to me. What am I reflecting to you? I know what you're reflecting to me. Lots of things, and I don't even know who you are, but I know that your energy is coming to me and you're reflecting things back to me. So you don't necessarily have to meet face to face. It's about the awareness. Okay, if you have any questions about that, shoot us a question on Twitter, Are You Awakening? And until next time, don't forget, always be you, all the time. Love.